At KMC, we like to share advice and best practices for controls and smart building systems. One question we are asked is, how do I choose between BACnet over IP or BACnet over MSTP for my network? These are the two most popular network types the BACnet communication protocol supports. If given the choice between the two, the building geniuses at KMC recommend BACnet over IP. The advantages fall under three main categories: performance and bandwidth, reliability, and installation efficiency and troubleshooting. Before we dive deeper, let's start with what BACnet is. BACnet stands for Building Automation and Control Networks. It's the most widely used standard protocol for building automation, created to simplify building automation equipment and open data communication. The standard brings increased interoperability across vendors, so you're not tied to a single device brand. BACnet also helps to consolidate workstations, making it easier for shared data to flow to one place rather than vendor-specific platforms. The industry also benefited by introducing integrated and standardized BAS functions like data sharing, alarming, event management, trending, scheduling, and remote management. BACnet not only works as a communication protocol, but it also defines and describes the object types and services that BACnet devices support. These rules and standards are known as BIBs, or BACnet Interoperable Building Blocks. So, unlike other communication protocols that focus only on how the messages move or data is transferred, BACnet has built in standard behaviors for devices that live on the network and how these are discovered by and share information to other devices or software. BACnet supports 7 types of networks and physical media to connect devices. The two most prevalent used today are BACnet over IP and BACnet over MSTP. The IP in BACnet over IP is Internet Protocol, one of the main protocols that allow computers to talk with each other over a network. BACnet over IP allows for communication between different IP subnets, multi-campus, control systems, and can even use fiber and gigabit Ethernet. Communications in BACnet over IP rely upon the protocol rules of IP and Ethernet. With BACnet over MSTP, each device is wired via RS-485, twisted pair serial cabling, daisy-chained together into one network. Communication is based around passing tokens, which is a way for devices on the same MSTP network to take turns initiating conversations with other devices. Only master type of devices can have the token and request data or send data without being specifically requested. Sensors are sometimes manufactured to operate as slave devices, and they can only send messages when specifically requested. They never have the token. All KMC devices are masters and can talk on the network directly. So why do we recommend BACnet over IP more than MSTP? First off, better performance and bandwidth. IP is very fast because the physical medium is based on Ethernet rather than serial. Most BACnet over IP devices support 100 megabit Ethernet, some even faster. 100 megabit Ethernet means 100 million bits flying on the wire every second. Compare this to the fastest BACnet over MSTP network, which is just 115,000 bits per second. Typically, Ethernet is almost 1,000 times faster than the fastest MSTP. In reality, because of the way Ethernet and BACnet work and the handshaking between requesting and responding devices, the actual usable bandwidth available for BACnet over IP messaging is typically only a few hundred times more than BACnet over MSTP. That being said, more systems today want to consume more data, such as front-end software, integration platforms, and analytics programs, making more bandwidth increasingly necessary. Plus, the communication speeds are typically more reliable with Ethernet because of the quality of the cable installation. Secondly, scalability. you can have more controllers per network on Ethernet than the MSTP. By the standard, MSTP networks are limited to 128 MSTP master nodes, all taking turns sharing the same single token, one at a time. BACnet over IP can have many hundreds of devices, and they do not have to wait for a token to initiate messages. Third, BACnet over IP network can be easier to troubleshoot than MSTP. When a MSTP network is not communicating well, it is not always easy to find where the trouble spot is, because communication for all devices on the network could be affected, making many of them look bad. BACnet over IP devices aren't nearly as susceptible to communication issues with one device affecting multiple devices on the same network as MSTP devices are. For devices that have a single Ethernet port, each device has its own dedicated Ethernet cable. Such devices, though, can greatly increase the cost of cabling by having all these individual cables run back to a single switch. But KMC devices have two Ethernet ports, which can be used to daisy chain the Ethernet cabling one to another for substantial cabling savings. If the switch has rapid spanning tree protocol enabled, messages can go in both directions in the daisy chain. From a physical wiring perspective, Ethernet and IP have much better fault tolerance in cabling, with less chance of interference and wires wiggling free from the terminals. Overall, BACnet over IP gives you more flexibility and can lead to increased installation efficiency. It affords the opportunity to leverage existing IT infrastructures and IT budgets. It supports any network topology, star, ring, or daisy chain architecture, and can use a variety of media. It is more reliable, has higher bandwidth, and is easier to troubleshoot. For these reasons, we recommend BACnet over IP. For more information on BACnet protocol, check out our BACnet 101 video link below. And to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.